Good morning, students. We continue with the lecture of Chapter 8, Women, Caste and Reform. In the last lecture, we had spoken about the women and how did they prosper. And it was an evolution process. It was slow, gradual, and then at last they succeeded in reaching the university level of education and leaving a mark in the society. I had missed out a point in the last lecture of child marriage. The reformers did work on this point also, and they saw to it that a law was passed where the age of a girl would be 16 when she had to get married and the boy should be 18. Now that also has risen up to 18 and 21 respectively. Today we start off with the reforms which took place in the caste system. Like as I said earlier in my lecture also, the most powerful caste was the Brahmins. And then came the Kshatriyas, then came the Vaishyas and the Sudras. Sudras were considered to be the low caste, the untouchables. So the reformers not only worked on the social evils which were being practiced on the women, but they also worked on the caste system. Raja Ramon Roy to be the best example, because he was the one who used to take reference texts from the sacred texts which we had in our society, from the ancestors, whatever was written in the society. He used to take references from there and prove it that there was no such kind of practice. For caste system, he took a reference of the Buddhist texts and then he proved that there was no caste system to be prevailing in the society, and he promoted the thought of bhakti where irrespective of the caste which a person belonged to, could gain the spiritual knowledge from his guru, no matter what creed, what color, what caste he belonged to. So that is how he promoted the idea of not following the caste system. Not only that, there were some upper Brahmins who were in support of this ideology. They used to conduct secret meetings, and this taboo of not eating with the people who belong to the lower caste, not touching them, they used to bring to an end to this kind of a system in their secret meetings. Not they did not do it in openly because they were not that powerful, but still they would build in a self-confidence in the people when they would eat along with them and they would speak to them, they would touch them, that would boost up the self-esteem of the lower caste people. Not only this, Christian missionaries started educating the children of the scheduled caste and scheduled caste, the lower caste people. So when education, they started becoming literates, then also their confidence was boosted up. So let's discuss about the job pattern of the people who were belonging to the lower caste. Now because they were pressurized so much by the upper caste society in the villages, they decided to leave the villages and migrate to the cities in search of jobs, either to the cities or in the nearby villages to look for jobs. Now, would they get job without being literates? That was a question to be answered. So, no would be the answer, because the menial jobs which are available in the cities, like the cleaning of the gutters or cleaning of the roads or laying the roads or clearing of the working in a construction at a construction site, these kind of jobs were taken up by the people who belong to the lower caste, still deteriorating their condition. Not only in India, they used to go abroad also and do the such kind of work only where they were paid, but not that much when compared to a literate person, how much a literate person would earn. So one very good example is of those people who used to work with leather. Now leather is the skin of an animal, and you wouldn't peel off the animal's skin when it is alive. So these people, this Madigas, this was a community called Madigas from Andhra Pradesh. These people used to deal with the dead animal's skin. They would pull it off and then make goods out of it. So they were considered to be that job was considered to be very menial, and that's why they were considered to be untouchables, because they dealt with the skin of the dead animals and they would smell. That was a very tough job to do. It would smell bad, foul smell would be there all around the areas where these people would be living, so they were not given that much of respect by the society. No, but you'll be amazed to hear that these people could join army because there was one regiment in the army called Mahar Regiment in this particular caste B.R. Ambedkar belonged to, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar belonged to, who was called the father of the constitution. So this person's father used to work in an army school. He was an educator over there, he was a teacher over there. So the people of the Mahar community could join the Mahar Regiment. So that was one of the jobs they could get. Now slowly, as they started becoming literate, even the non-Brahmins took part in the movement where they fought for equality and justice for the people of the lower caste. So certain movements, examples have been cited in your textbooks. In central India, there was one movement called the Sainami movement. They worked in for the benefitment of the leather workers. They fought for their rights. In East Bengal, there was a person named Haridas. He questioned the Brahmanical texts where this kind of discrimination process was discussed in those texts. He counter-questioned as to why did these things happen and what was the reason of in history that these kind of things happen and why this particular treatment is being met with the people of the lower caste. And there was one person from the Izawa caste in Kerala. He was a guru. He also protested against the ill treatment which was shown towards these people who are of the lower caste. He coined a term saying, or like this is in Malayalam, he coined a term saying, Oru Jati, Oru Matam, Oru Daivam, Manushyanu. That means, Oru Jati means we belong to one particular community, then we belong to one particular religion, and we belong to one God. That is humanity. That's a literal translation of the terminology is what he used over here. So all these protests, all these reforms, all these movements led to a boost in the confidence, the self-esteem, the respect of a human, what he has to have for himself, of those people who belong to the lower castes. So what further happened, what happened further in the society will be discussed in the next lecture. That's all for today. Thank you.